गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडीड अबाउट द हाउ डज द पार्लियामेंट कंट्रोल द एग्जीक्यूटिव. इन टूडेज लेक्चर आई विल एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द डिफरेंट कमिटीज अंडर द पार्लियामेंट एंड हाउ दे फंक्शन. एंड दिस इज द लास्ट पार्ट, सेवेंथ लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 5. A significant feature of the legislative process is the appointment of committees for various legislative purposes. These committees play a vital role not merely in lawmaking but also in the day-to-day business of the House. Because Parliament meets only during session, it has very limited time at its disposal. The lawmaking process, for instance, requires in-depth study or deep study of the issue under consideration. This in turn demands more attention and time similarly. There are other important functions also, like studying the demands for grants made by various ministers, looking into expenditure incurred by various departments, investigating cases of corruption, etc. Parliament committees perform such a functions with full of responsibilities. Under Parliament, mainly the two type of committees are there. First, parliamentary standing committees. Second, joint parliamentary committees. First, parliamentary standing committees, approximate 20 such departmentally committees are working in this category. And standing committees supervises the work of various departments, their budget, their expenditure and bills of that come up in the house relating to the department. Next, joint parliament committees. They can be set up for the purpose of discussing a particular bill, like the joint committee to discuss bill, or for the purpose of investigating financial irregularities. Members of these committees are selected from both the houses. And now the important functions of these committees are, the committee system has reduced the burden on the parliament. Means parliament has a wide range of works and these committees carries their work. Helps in lawmaking process. If you have attended the lecture of lawmaking process, in that I have mentioned about the committees. And deep study regarding the bill or law is done by these committees. Deep study of issues of law which is not possible by all the members. Next, studying the demand for grants by various ministers is also study by these committees. Looking the expenditure of different departments are also done by these committees. Investigation of corruption cases or related such a type of cases are also investigated by these committees. And now we will study the post by which Parliament regulate its work. In this category, first is presiding officers. Both the houses have presiding officers who regulates the behavior of its members and look after day-to-day work or punishes the members who are not following the rules of the house. Speaker and Deputy Speaker in the Lok Sabha and Chairman and Vice Chairman in the Rajya Sabha. Second, anti-defection law. It was passed in 1985 by 52nd Amendment and was also modified in the 91st Amendment. It is the proof that a MP has changed the party after winning the election. This is important. After winning the election or not voted according to the instructions of party, then presiding officer of the house can punish him. He can be dismissed from the house. He can be disqualified from holding any political office. And now, what is defection? Changing the party after winning the election. If a member remains absent in the house when asked by the party leadership to remain present or vote against the instructions of the party or voluntarily leaves the membership of the party is deemed as defection. And in the earlier times, many MPs or MLAs were habitual to do this practice. But after two amendments, 52nd Amendment and 91st Amendments, it is considered as a crime and no MP or MLAs is allowed to do defection. I hope all the points are clear to you. If you face any problem, you can ask. Thank you and have a nice day.